Hi guys, welcome everyone. Hi Sarang. Welcome guys. Hey Lucky, what's up? Hi Sudarshan. Hi Yash. Hi Mr. Lost One. So everybody, a warm welcome to Entrepreneur India. Hi everybody. Hey Haran. So guys, welcome to the next episode of Lighten Up. This is Priyadarshini Patwa, the features editor with Entrepreneur India. Last week we spoke about vegan movement, conscious beauty choices, and why are we moving towards vegan products. This week we have someone very interesting with us. This man needs no introduction, loved by millions. He is the most popular YouTuber and influencer. So today we have our live with Ranveer Alabadia, who is popularly known as Beer Biceps. So we are going to just invite him and let's get to know everything about content.
What is happening on social media? Also guys, whoever is an inspiring influencer, content creator, make sure you post your questions and we're going to ask him everything. Hi Ranveer.
Hi Beer, how's it going?
Great, yeah. What's up with you?
The usual, just getting set with my lockdown life again. So I've just figured out my schedule over these last 4 months, and my day doesn't begin before this time. So you're the first thing, your first commitment I have today.
Well, so that is a wonderful thing, because I remember that, you know, for a while I wanted you on our next episode, and finally we have you here. So very excited. So as you were talking about your schedule, so, you know, how about you start with telling us that because the lockdown has totally changed the content creation and your lives of all the content creator, how is it happening with you?
So in terms of content, a lot of our content that we create has changed. The topics I write about has completely changed because people just have different needs right now. In terms of my private schedule, because I teach people information, I have to read a lot of information also to be able to teach. And in real life, I didn't get that chance to read as much as I had to. So now from like, say, 12 a.m. to about 3 a.m., always, sometimes 4 a.m., I'm just reading a lot of stuff, you know, just trying to refuel. And that's actually been the priority in lockdown as a creator, to kind of refuel my own head. And then I get up late, I get up around, say, I start shooting around this time. You know, like the rest of the day is a little slow. But I prefer this more work at night kind of zone.
So, you know, Ranveer, like we all know that you started as a fitness influencer. You were talking about your journey. So was it a conscious choice to pick that particular subject?
So honestly, it was something that I was very into back in college, fitness. And I just thought that, you know, let's kind of teach the world what I've learned over the last 4 years of college. So it was just that. I also initially thought that I'll become the guy who owns gym chains all over the world and all. Thank God I didn't do that. Eventually I realized that I shouldn't just limit myself to fitness. I should do other stuff also. And then grooming, etc.
So, you know, that's what my next question was about to be, that you have diversified into tons of content. You talk about fashion, grooming. You also give financial advices out there. And you are also you also create motivational videos. So most of the people stick to one niche. Was it like, were you skeptical that, you know, agar main itna sara content mein jaunga, to ho sakta hai lose people or my audience?
No, I feel like we experimented a lot, and you need to always see how your audience is, how your numbers are reacting to your experiments. That's all you have to be conscious about. So once we figured that, okay, people like fashion content done by us, we continued down that line. And when we wanted to start talking about mental fitness, we saw people like all this meditation content, you know, content around anxiety, things like that. People enjoy watching that. So your audience always tells you what you should be creating. And at the same time, as a creator, you should be responsible. You should do a good job with your research, all that. So as long as you're playing that game, it's pretty safe.
All right, so we have a lot of people. Somebody is also saying, can they see your biceps?
Oh God, it's a little, I don't know, this is one aspect of my job, always objectify my own body, I'm kidding.
Okay, and so you know, because you are so much into fitness, and fitness is the new mantra we really need to follow, because this is a time when we need to be mentally and physically both fit. So what are the 5 tips you would give to every people out there to make sure they are at best of their fitness?
As much as you can, minimize eating dessert. That's what I always tell people. It'll just cut off a lot of excess calories, a lot of wrong kinds of things that you're putting inside your body, because dessert is made up of maida, sugar, and a lot of fat, which is not healthy for you. So if you can minimize it, great. You know, limit yourself to once a week. Secondly, keep your kitchen a little free of chakna. Like, I think that's one big reason Indians actually end up losing their health, because of all the snacks and all we eat once in a while. Third, I'd say do any kind of movement for sure. Whatever you know you want to do, whether that's walking, weight training, yoga, anything, but definitely move your body. Even if it means doing jhadu pocha at home, do that. But like, you know, just ensure that your body is moving in some way.
Mm-hmm.
Fourth, I'd probably say enjoy yourself also. Like, keep your cheat meals present in the week. Once, twice a week, it's perfectly fine. If you can reduce it to one, nothing like it. But even twice a week, it's all right. And finally, I'd say that definitely meditate also, because meditate builds your focus, your discipline, and you need those things in your fitness journey. So don't ignore meditation.
So, you know, this is the time when we see that a lot of people are also moving towards social media. I think it's more of a digital revolution that has taken place. And I believe that people didn't think that, you know, we would move to a whole digital era altogether. So because you are yourself an entrepreneur, and you have a company of your own that focuses so much on digital growth, what are a few tips you would tell to, what are a few mistakes? Before you give tips, I would want to know what are a few mistakes that brands and creators make on social media?
Okay, brands, honestly, I feel like brands make the mistake of kind of creating campaigns for creators, and when they're doing influencer marketing, they just tell them, ki aise aise karo, ye aise hi karna aapko. So that's wrong. You need to give the creator the independence and the you know, freedom to market brands how they want. That's what the brands do wrong. In terms of creators, I feel like people need to be present on multiple social media platforms. People think that just by being present on Instagram, they can build their career. It's not as simple as that. And honestly, when you're on two or three platforms together, they all feed off of each other. So you should be on YouTube, but also on Instagram, on LinkedIn, but also on Twitter. If you can do all these, nothing like it. And that's what you should build towards, honestly, if you're an individual creator.
So, you know, from a very content point of view, when we talk about building business, so I think a lot of creators are struggling with combining it into also a money, earning a resource. So how would you tell people that, you know, aap content create kar sakte ho, isse revenue bhi generate kar sakte ho?
I feel initially in the one year that you start, it will be difficult. You have to figure out how to make money in that 1 year. So when I was making fitness videos, the obvious thing was I'll be noticed by people who want to become fitter. Hello, can you hear me?
Hello.
You can hear me, Priya?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
I think I'm losing you in between.
Okay. Are we better now?
Yeah. Better.
Okay. Yeah. So basically, I was saying, in your first year, you need to figure out how to make money. I knew that my audience is a fitness centric audience. So I actually started training people back in my first year. So you have to do some jugaad to earn money in your first year. But after that, money comes. So even if it means taking a loan for 1 year, but you're very sure that you will grow, I think you should take a loan from someone in the family, you know, something that you can pay off easily. But if you can earn money through some skill that you know, nothing like it. If you can go to office but then treat this as a side hustle, nothing like it.
You know, like with you, because you are in so many diversified content, and the good thing is there are very less influencers who can also ace in all those content. Exact. Not everybody can do it. So how do a creator make sure ki yaar wo apna niche kaise find karta hai ya expertise, because we sometimes the feeds are so, you know, scattered that it's very difficult to understand ki what this creator is trying to prove. So how do you find
I feel that movement? Yeah, I feel you should make content around the thing you think of the most. So if you're thinking about funny thoughts the most, you automatically should become a comedy creator. For me, it was always fitness. I was always thinking about fitness, and as I grew up, other thoughts came to my head. I started thinking about mental health. I started thinking about grooming. I started thinking about personal finance. So once those thoughts come into your head, then it's about exercising that muscle. That's why you have to read a lot if you're a creator. You have to absorb a lot of information. That's the, I don't want to call it downside of this game, but that's the effort that you have to put in. That's your training. And then when you're performing, it's all the information you've accumulated. So that's how you should look at it.
You are a serial entrepreneur because you own multiple companies now. So how did the whole journey of entrepreneurship begin for you?
I always wanted to do this. Like I look at myself always as a businessman first, then a YouTuber. And I've always had that intention because even YouTube started with that intention of starting some kind of startup. And I just figured that a startup can also be in the digital space. That's why let me start a YouTube channel. So it's always been that goal. And the goal has always been that once, and I feel that this is the should be the goal for anyone who wants to enter entrepreneurship or business. You should ask yourself first, what industry do I want to enter? Enter at the base level, do something in that industry. I always knew I wanted to enter media. So that's how I entered media through the path of being a YouTuber. And once you understand what's happening, it's very easy to set up businesses because you understand, okay, I can help you, I can help you, I can create a team that can help you, I can create a team that can help you. So it's about entering the industry, working a little bit, and then assembling a very, very good, smart team. That's all I feel.
So I mean, when brands reach out to you because you have become a brand in yourself. So are there times that you feel that, yeah, these things are not matching with my principles or what I follow? Do you, just because of money, do you sign up for with those brands, or do you try to draw a balance that, how you would make
So,
sure that your principle is not getting sabotaged in between?
when you're doing YouTube, it's not, you become famous and it's not like Bollywood famous, it's YouTube famous. That means that in Bollywood, people will like you for your acting, for your dancing, for your action, for how you look. On YouTube, people like you for what is inside your brain. Like you're taking out your opinions and putting it out, you're taking out your perspectives and putting it out. Your audience knows you even better than your family sometimes. In my case, is that my family doesn't watch my YouTube, but all my audience watches what's happening in my life. So, if you ever talk about a brand that you yourself aren't going to use, your audience will catch that also. And it's something I've maintained from day one that I'll never promote any brand that I don't use in my own life. Because the long-term game is, it's like a 20, 30-year game. It's not a 3, 4-year game at all. Some people do look at it like a 3, 4-year game, but I look at it like a very, very long-term game. So I don't want to lose my audience's trust by just, saying, "Oh, okay, give me 1 crore for this branding." I don't want it. It's fine. Like there are some things which are more important than money, and I feel that long-term relationship you're building with your audience is way more important than money.
I think that's a very important point you have made, and all the aspiring entrepreneurs and also influencers who are sitting on the feed, do remember what Ranveer is saying, because that really makes a huge difference. Okay, another thing, I'm sure everybody wants to know this because a lot of people are really talking about your fitness and your biceps. So what is your fitness routine like?
Actually, lockdown has made me very, very, very fit. And that's mainly because I've stopped ordering as much from all those food delivery apps. I think that was the main culprit in normal life because of coronavirus fears and all. Initially, I'd stopped ordering and then later it just became a habit. So I feel it's primarily about the food you put inside your body. At the same time, again, some kind of movement I do every day. So the least I'll do is I'll at least go for a walk in a garden or something, like I'll do something. That's what I intend on doing right after this live stream. Actually, I'm going to go to a garden near my house, just walk around and do nothing else. But I feel that I do a lot of weight training even now. I actually ended up, so I have an office space near my house and I've set up a gym within that office. So I'm going and I started working out again. And this is honestly the fittest I've ever been. I also do like a lot of yoga, at least twice, thrice a week. I'll end up doing some yoga stretches just to stretch out my body, which also changes the way you look a little bit. But it's mainly about just focusing on getting your protein in. So I'll have like two plant protein shakes, one big bowl of khichdi, lots of chole. Sometimes maybe twice, thrice a week I'll have tofu. I'm vegetarian completely, so no eggs also. And maybe on only on like Sundays I'll have like one serving of paneer or something, and I'll order, I'll eat my cheat meal on Sunday, because I mean I'm also human, so I want to eat butter paneer every Sunday. That's my
Oh my
thing.
God, every Sunday butter paneer.
Yeah, it's
So
from
you know
this
when you're
place called
talking about
Goila,
like
but
cheap meals,
yeah.
I think I'm losing you in between again, a little.
No, go on, go on. I can hear you.
Yeah, you were telling me where do you order your butter paneer from?
I ordered from this place called Goila. Goila. It's owned by one of my friends called Saranj Goila.
I know,
And
I
yeah, so he's got these two, three paneer dishes, which are like the best things I've had in my life. So honestly, even today is a Friday. I'm so close to the Sunday. The whole week I've eaten clean, but I'm just thinking about my Sunday lunch. So if you really want to achieve a certain level of fitness, you have to kind of treat your mind like that. You have to think of it as rewarding yourself. And if I have too much of an urge to order something, like if I want to eat something, I need like idli and no dosa, just idli and sambar or something, you know, which so it feels like it's outside food, but what is it? It's just steamed and sambar. So there's like nothing too intense about
So Ranvi, now that you're sitting at home and creating content, what are I'm sure there are so many ideas flowing in, right? And you have a team who helps you in work, who used to help you before. But how are you guys doing the whole team creation thing now?
We've set up remote work situation. So all on when the lockdown got announced, right before Modi ji actually made an announcement of a proper lockdown, there was this phase where everyone was just sitting at home. So we figured that this is what might happen. There might be an official lockdown. We went to office, we took all our editing equipment, PCs, all that, and got it delivered to all our main editors' houses. And then we also invested in remote working tools. Like, how can we access each other's PCs from our own PCs? How can we, you know, easily upload onto the drive storage system, things like that. So we got good internet connections installed in everyone's houses, and they're working nicely remotely. But honestly, it's like when you're creating a lot of videos, it's like playing in a band, and it the music gets created the best when you are together. So there is that thoda level of, you know, we wish that we could do more, but it's all right, it's fine.
Talking about the fashion sense of yours, I mean, there are people who love how you deck up and your collection of shoes and everything that you have. So, moving a little from the seriousness to the fashion aspect, what are a few things every man should have in their wardrobe? Like, hona hi hona chahiye, kuch ho na ho to bhi.
Definitely, I feel focus on your shoes a lot. So white sneakers, I will definitely suggest. I also suggest black formal shoes. These two things should be there. One very simple pair of jeans, like just dark blue jeans, it'll go with anything. Pair of black pants and one white shirt, one black shirt. I'll give you six items. If you just have these things, you can change up your looks. You can do all kinds of things. But then obviously, I feel that if you really want to take it to the next level, guys should start wearing more color, especially in Mumbai. Very, very few people focus on the fashion sense and all. Like when I go to places like Delhi, you know, you can see even the guys care about how they dress. But in Mumbai, it's very less. It's not really that important how you dress. So I feel that more guys need to care about what they're putting on themselves before they're going out. And I do feel like lockdown is getting lifted soon, so we will start seeing people getting out of their houses now.
But considering that lockdown is still there and we are part of all virtual events, so I'm going to ask you a few, the things, and you have to tell me how they can dress up for that particular thing via videos. Okay? Like, for example, let's say a video interview that we are doing, something like that. What should one wear?
How do you dress for a video interview? You can wear whatever you want down there, like boxers, pajamas, whatever. But up here, you gotta wear a shirt at least if it's a formal interview. Don't wear a t-shirt. That's what I'll suggest. It just gives out a certain vibe. You want to look a little
Are you
professional.
wearing like a shorts or a pajama down?
No, I wear a lot of athleisure clothing. So basically, this is the same. So I have like one bath in the day after my gym, and I gym at night. So I'll wait. I'm just wearing the same pair of athleisure shorts because athleisure is very comfortable. You can actually go out of your house and go shopping in it. Looks good. It's comfortable. Athleisure clothing is like what I recommend during lockdown, honestly.
Okay, so video conferences.
For video conferences, again, I mean, okay, you know, if you want to make it casual, you wear something like this, where there is a collar, but at the same time, it's a t-shirt. So you're formal enough, and at the same time, you're casual enough. But if it's just your friends or something, then you can wear a t-shirt, you can wear a v-neck, you can wear anything, a ganji, whatever you want.
And for virtual dates, like nowadays, people are doing a lot of virtual dates. इनफैक्ट शादी का तो सब कुछ वर्चुअल ही हो गया है. सो फॉर दैट हाउ वुड यू लाइक अप.
There's something called cardigans, which guys actually don't wear. Now I wear a lot of cardigans. I've seen that it. I don't know. It suits my personality, but I also feel generally, the ladies love guys in their cardigans, or at least like a very thin jacket or something. You know, something like that, just to look a little fresh.
Talking about your podcast, you have also started the Ranveer show, and people are loving it. You have had Priyanka Chopra, then Rajkumar Rao. And a lot of other popular personalities from other fields of life. So, you know, podcasts have become a new trend and India is still adapting to it. So you are still among the starters who are launching into that, but your show is doing pretty well. So how did the whole concept of this come into your head?
I've been watching podcasts since 2011 when I was an engineering college student, and I'd gained a lot from podcasts. I always knew that at some point they'll come in India, and I knew that. So podcast, it's not as easy as just sitting with someone and talking. There's a skill required, which takes time to learn. So even if you watch some of our older podcasts, they're very bad. They're not good. Like, I have not done it well. But once I cracked the game and I saw that, okay, people respond to it. A lot of young people basically want to know the same things that you as a podcast interviewer are thinking. You know, in front of Saif Ali Khan, you want to ask him a few questions. Everyone will have the same 4 or 5 questions for him. So it's just about that, like tapping into what the audiences want. I just feel we've done that correct, and that's what works for it. Also, consistency, releasing a lot of quantity of content. We make sure that every week we'll release at least one. So that's important.
All right. So now we will take some questions from the viewers here, because there are a lot of people who totally love you. And I can see like everybody just wants me to shut up so that they can we can have you answer their question. Okay. So one of the question is, I want to start fitness YouTube channel in Telugu language. It's by Mukesh Kumar. Any tips regarding it?
Very good idea. Just start. There's very few regional niche channels. You'll make a lot of money through even online coaching. Online coaching can pay you up to even like if you play a very hardworking smart game, you can earn up to 50 lakhs a month. And I'm not making that up. So there's a lot of money to be made. Definitely start.
Oh God, 50 lakhs a month, dude. I like really feel underpaid, yaar. Pehle journalist underpaid hoti hai, to aur underpaid feel ho raha
hai. I mean, it's one of those, like you need to give all of yourself to it. So there are downsides also. But my point is, there's a lot of money in the YouTube game, not just through brand deals. You, because of your fame, you can start coaching a lot of people. You can start mentoring people. So there are lots of ways to make money. It's not just like brandies. So, but then again, it's a lot of work.
We have someone named Max who is asking that how can I be an entrepreneur?
First, work in under an entrepreneur. That's what I'll suggest. And see what life is like one-on-one. Understand how business works. Understand the downside of entrepreneurship. And then ask yourself, do you really want to enter that zone and do it?
Okay, Vikas wants to know that who will feature in your next podcast, Ranveer?
Prateek Kuhad, actually. We recorded one episode with Prateek Kuhad yesterday. And it was a very heavy episode, but very nice. It's all about love, relationships. And he's a very smart guy. So today's podcast features Riaz Amlani, who's like India's top restaurateur. He owns Smokehouse Delhi, Social, all these places. And he's talking about how coronavirus affected that. Next week or the week after, we will have Prateek Kuhad. And I'm also trying to get Seema Aunty from Indian Matchmaking. So let's see.
Ooh, oh my God. Can you sing? Is it that you sing as well and we don't know?
No, I actually don't. I just have a very nice voice and that's it. I can't.
I mean, that is right. Like people are actually saying that they're loving how you're talking and they're of course not liking my voice. I have read those comments also.
No, nothing like that. This is podcast jugaad. Like you have to figure out how to control your voice, and this is something I've been able to do over a year. But don't worry about that.
There's another person, Tanmay, who's asking, please suggest some protein, some good plant proteins.
I'm actually making a few detailed videos on plant protein, so I'm going to hold back on that suggestion right now. But just when you're buying a plant protein, look for whether or not it's stevia sweetened. Stevia is a natural herbal sweetener. The issue with proteins usually are that they have a lot of additives, a lot of artificial sweeteners, which actually harm your health. So as long as something is free of an artificial sweetener, look for that.
Okay, one of the person wants to know that if somebody already have a base of 100 subscribers on YouTube, so how do you increase subscribers more?
You put out more content. You stay consistent with releasing. It's like as simple as that. And honestly, it's not as complicated as people make it. You know, key like, what should I do? How should I do? You just keep doing things and then you'll figure yourself.
Another question we have is from VVK. He's saying this pandemic has changed our fashion sector. What type of content in fashion niche should we focus on?
I actually don't, because I also run a Hindi channel, which is mainly a fashion and grooming channel. And our fashion videos haven't been getting responses because I just think people have lost an interest in clothing. So it will reopen, you know, around Diwali and all that. But for now, try other forms of content. That's what I'll say. Talk about confidence and all that's also attached to fashion. So, you know, do fashion content once the lockdown is lifted.
Arthur wants to know, don't you think YouTube is saturated?
I mean, it's how you look at it. When I had started out also, people had told me, why are you doing a fitness channel? It's saturated. There's already so much fitness out there. Like every guy in my gym that I used to go to used to tell me that, no, why are you doing this? You're wasting your life. But it's about who you want to listen to, what you want to believe. So honestly, if you really search within, you can find good original content to make that people will enjoy watching.
So, Ranvi, you also focus a lot on self-improvement. I just read someone talking about that as well. So when we talk about self-improvement, what are a few elements that one needs to remember? Because, you know, this is a time when we are feeling so low and gloomy. So how do you make sure to be, like, positive all the time?
I feel self-improvement doesn't have to be difficult. It can be some very small, easy things that you can do. Like, you know what they say about books is that everyone is actually a reader and everyone enjoys reading. It's just that everyone hasn't found that book that they enjoy reading. So if you find something you enjoy reading, you'll read it very fast. And I feel that self-improvement is the same thing. When you find an activity that you realize, oh, wow, I'm enjoying it also and I'm growing in some way or the other, it'll come very naturally to you. And in the lockdown especially, that's something you should look into. So for me, it's reading like particular kinds of books that are fueling my content and therefore I'm able to make more videos, all that kind of stuff. But just kind of get, only the first step is difficult. You know, it's not difficult after that. So just jump in and try different things.
So there are a few people who want to do internship under your company, Mark Entertainment. They're asking how can they get internship with you?
You apply at careers@beerbiceps.com or careers@monkey.in, monk-e.in.
Right. Is there a hack how they can get in easily, or what do you actually look in a talent before getting hired?
Yeah. One or two fan pages of Beer Biceps actually just created a lot of content themselves around the channel, and we've hired them for internships because they already showed us that, okay, this is the kind of work I will do without waiting for us to give instructions. They just like impressed us with like a slap in the face. So we had to like hire them.
So guys, jinko bhi chahiye ki wo Ranbir ke saath kaam kare, yaar impression jamao, thoda sa acha sa, unke bare mein content create karo, and you never know, you might get lucky. Okay.
Something
like that. Another question we have is, diet for beginners, it's too hard to increase diet initially.
It's too hard to increase the numbers, followers?
I think what they mean to say that it's too difficult to get into the diet initially itself when you are a beginner.
Cut out one wrong thing at a time. So first cut off dessert, then when you're comfortable with that, next you cut off maida, next you cut off white rice, things like that. So tackle one thing at a time. Even if it takes you 1 month to completely reduce your dessert intake, you know, just have like one bit of dessert on like a Sunday and that's enough. Eventually then move on to cutting off maida, chakna, Maggi, things like that.
I have a very interesting question for you. Karishma wants to know how to be friends with you.
I don't have a social life. My social life, unfortunately, are my co-founders. And, you know, that's pretty much it. So at this stage of my life, I'm studying. But maybe when I'm over 30 years old and YouTube and all is done, we can be friends then. So that time.
So Rani, what kind of entrepreneur are you and what kind of creator are you?
In terms of entrepreneurship, I'm almost never satisfied. Like I feel like no matter how much is done, like there has to be something else to do. And in terms of being a creator, I feel it's much more about impact creation than I see Zakir Bhai here saying Ranveer, please guide us how to be sexy and so I think I'm being a creator, I'm inspired by kind of what Zakir Bhai does, where it's that whole neki kar darya mein fek, just put out good content and it's fine, whatever happens happens. So I would say that, but as an entrepreneur, I'm very hungry. I feel like I've not even begun properly my entrepreneurial journey. So there's a lot left to do.
Okay, so now that Zakir has also joined our life and he wants to actually know that how to be as sexy as you, I think you totally have to reply to that.
Oh my God. Have friends like Zakir Khan to give you very sexy things to say in your head. Then you'll never run out of things to say in conversation. That's what I would suggest. No, but really, I think if you just get into the habit of being better at conversation, people, not just girls, everyone, guys, girls, boys, everyone finds it like attractive. So just make people around you feel comfortable, talk to people. That's what I'll suggest.
So, Randy, who are your inspirations? Because we always, take some or the other inspiration from people. Who are you inspired from?
Definitely Virat Kohli, LeBron James, Arnold Schwarzenegger. I'd probably say these three names straight off the top. But yeah, Virat Kohli would probably be right at the top of that list.
So, as an entrepreneur, last two questions I'm going to ask you. As an entrepreneur, what is next in your closet, and what is that one should wait for that हम लोग को अभी तक पता नहीं है, and you're going to come up with something.
I'm trying to create a much like I'm trying to create a product which people can use. That's all I'll say right now. It's a digital product that will be in people's hands. So for example, right now Monk Entertainment is more on the B2B side. It's more on like the service side. But I'm trying to create something that's B2C. It's going to be virtual. It's going to be some kind of an app. So I'm trying to build that, but let's see. It's like honestly, what people don't see online is I've tried 10, 15 businesses and only Beer Bicycle and Monk Entertainment have worked. All the other ones have failed. So that's the truth of entrepreneurship, that you fail a lot. So while I'm trying to work at this, let's see where it goes.
Talking about the present time, we see there's a lot of negativity on social media and so much trolls out there. So how do you try to create an optimistic surrounding and make sure that, social media becomes a less of a hatred place?
I personally have this thing of just continuously doing things, building things, writing content, creating content. So I keep my mind very busy. And what I always tell young creators is early on, and this is something Tanmay told me when I had started, or Tanmay Bhatt from AIB. He said that very early on, you have to become a little tough towards it because it's going to, as you keep growing, it'll keep increasing. So honestly, that's my answer, that just become tough with it. Like it's okay if it comes your way. Don't respond and keep yourself busy. Keep doing the next thing. You should be much more bothered about, okay, what's my next content piece or what's my next article than, "Arey, this 13-year-old boy from somewhere told me that like I'm not good." Like, oh, that doesn't make any sense.
Okay, lastly, because people love you so much and you have over a million people who really listen to what you're saying, so one thing you would actually, a tip that you would give to everyone out there who are trying to make their bet.
Start meditating. It's even more important than your fitness, especially in the times that we live in, where there's so many mental health issues and just negativity out there. Have a positive habit in your life like meditation. That's what I'll suggest.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Ranveer, for giving us your wonderful time. And I hope you enjoyed
I did. This was a lot of fun, Priyadarshini. We'll do this again sometime.
too. Yeah, I think even last time the conference went well, and now again having you here, I'm going to have you again in some of the other show, part of a panel.
I'm sure. I'm sure. We'll do it. Did you have fun?
I really liked how you were talking after a very long time and like a hectic work schedule that is going on. This is more of like a, let's say, relaxation moment for me.
Exactly, same. I'm looking at it the same way. This is my only social life right now. You are a big part of my social life right now, Priyadarshini, because otherwise I only talk to co-founders. So I always enjoy talking to you.
Wonderful, मतलब अच्छी बात है यार, आपका भी थोड़ा chill out हो गया, मेरा भी हो गया. All right, thank you so much, Ranveer. Bye bye. Have a great day.
Bye. See you.
See you. So guys, that was Beer Biceps, Ranveer Alabadia, and it was wonderful chatting with him. The man has told us everything, how you can create good content, how to actually create a following, what are the mistakes you make as a brand and a content creator, and also why meditation is so important. So for more information, you can just tune into our website. And also next Friday, we're going to have another one with us who is going to talk about something very exciting. Stay tuned and know who's going to be on the next episode of Lighten Up. Till then, have a great weekend. Bye-bye. Take care.